Paper is a revolutionary material. Paper-based devices are lightweight, inexpensive, easily disposable, and easy to handle. Most of the paper that we use comes from wood and grasses, but the chemical process is needed to remove other components and obtain cellulose, the main component of paper, the most abundant organic polymer on Earth. In our lab, we can also make cellulose. This is a film of bacterial cellulose. And how do we produce it? With sugar and bacteria. Yes, bacteria. Our small friend Acetobacter chilenum secretes cellulose from their skin pores. Look at these cellulose fibrils. We grow the bacteria colonies in agar plates at 30 degrees. That's what they like. And then cellulose is produced when the bacteria are fed in a culture media. The reason is still uncertain, but they do it. And what do we need to prepare it? We need peptone as amino acid source, we need yeast extract as nutritional source, and pH buffers such as citric acid and disodium phosphate. We mix it with water, and then we need the carbon source, which is glucose, the favorite dish of the bacteria, sugar. We sterilize the culture media in an autoclave to avoid possible contamination during growth, and separately, to avoid undesired reactions between sugar and amino acids. Once they are cooled down, we mix them together and we obtain the nutrient source. We place some of it in a flask, such as an Erlenmeyer, and then we add the bacteria. We let them sit at 30 degrees for 3 or 4 days. The longer time, the thicker the film will be. And ta-cha! We obtain a cellulose film on the interface liquid air. Depending on the flask used, the cellulose can have different shapes, circle or square. And before using it, we need to clean the cellulose from the bacteria that remains on the film. To this end, we first place the cellulose in ethanol, and then we wash it with boiling water first, and then with hot sodium hydroxide, a strong base. After this process, we obtain a transparent, wet cellulose membrane, which has very interesting properties and can be used in many different applications. An ultra-fine porous network with a high water holding capacity, crystalline, flexible, resistant, and that can also be chemically modified with different elements, such as inorganic nanoparticles or even colors. Once dried, the cellulose is like paper, a thin membrane, and you can even write on it. That's what we do in our lab, pure bacterial cellulose. Imagine all the possibilities that this material has in bio and energy applications.